after watching that film, I come to understand if I could work that hard every day, with the being blessed with the physical tools that I have, what would my career be? And I made a promise to myself from that day that I was going to work that hard every single day so that when I do retire, I have no regrets. And that was the most important thing for me, is to leave no stone unturned, get better every single day. And if I lived that way, then over time, you know, I'd have something that was beautiful. But that was my philosophy. It seems like a pretty simple one, but you know, if you live your life to just get better every single day, and do that for 20 years, I mean, what do you have?
My name is Joshua Larkin. I'm a first year at the University of Kent and I currently play basketball here as well. Man, where do I think my career is going in basketball? I realized God is really the author of life. So as far as God takes me, that's where my career is going.
So what motivates you and drives you to keep going?
What motivates me? So when I was younger, like my sisters and I went through a lot. Like with our financial situation, like we weren't really allowed outside as much. I think that's how basketball really came into my life as well. That's why when I started playing it clicked, because I could be in the back garden just playing basketball for hours and just get lost in my own world and not have to worry about like problems that you're going through. You just get lost in time. But yeah, what motivates me? I really wish to pay my parents back for all the amazing stuff that they've done for me. So I'm just working hard. I'm just working hard to really make it, but to be honest, I know that I have a lot of people that doubt me. Like in the past, a lot of people have told me stuff that they think I could do, and they've tried to put me in a box. And I really want to show them that, like, no matter what you said about me, I'm gonna make it my own way, and I don't have to listen to you, because it's my life and not yours. Yeah, the basketball's been calm. It's been blessed right now. So the season's almost over. It's kind of sad, like, met a couple people, met new people. It's nice seeing new faces. Like, I've made a lot of friends. So yeah, it's been a fun experience. It's kind of sad that the season's over though. But yeah. Right now it's just, so I try to go to the gym like every other week. So not like, cause I used to go consecutive, but like I realized it was too taxing on my body. So I try to go like Monday, then go Wednesday, then Friday, then Sunday. So I go to the gym around 5 a.m. because Pure Gym is too busy in the afternoon. And then after that, we have practice. We have practice at 7 to 9. And then after practice, I try doing my own little session for like a good 1-2 hours, get my own work in, and then have lectures for the rest of the day up to like 3. And after 3, there's a group chat that we have for scrimmages. So yeah, then after that, then I go to scrimmage and then come back, make food, and then yeah, that's it.
So I saw you listen to some music before.
Mm-hmm.
Who's your favorite artist? I already know it is, but let them know who your favorite.
T Grizzly for sure. T Grizzly.
But do you have a favorite song?
Definitely. My favorite song would definitely be First Day Out by T Grizzly. First Day Out, banger. Like, I don't know if you can hear it. Actually, no, you can't hear it. It's in my AirPods. What am I talking about? But definitely First Day Out, tough. Like, it just gets you hyped. Like, even if you're in the layup line, First Day Out, just give you that energy. But I can't lie, I haven't been listening to a lot of like secular music. Like, they're trying to switch up a bit. So there's another Christian rapper, his name is Caleb Gordon and Lecrae. So I like to switch up a bit, because sometimes when you actually pay attention to what you're listening to, it's like, okay, I need to chill out a bit. But yeah, T Grizzly for sure.
These niggas prayed on my downfall.
Like, what?
These niggas prayed on my downfall. Ooh. On R10, bitch, I stood tall.
You did?
Show these disloyal niggas how to boil. Go get a thermometer for the pot. I need this shit cooked right. Let's keep that water 400 degrees Fahrenheit. You ever been inside a federal courtroom? Nigga, you ever went to trial and fought for your life? Being broke did something to my spirit. Ass niggas to plug me. They act like they couldn't hear me. Look at me not driving German engineering. You don't want your baby mama fucked. Keep the hoe from near me, Kilroy. Remember when I used to use your ills to hit the road, hit the O and make them big boy sales? Move. Remember when you had them green things mailed with vacuum seals, trying not to have them green things smell? Feds was on me. What you know about related through money? I don't know nothing. I just used to see them walk to the Coney. I fuck with bitches. My body count go from Persian to Cody. Any further questions? You could take that up with the lawyer. My nigga Finkel J Money, Brightmo Low Project Joe will tell you every day before school. I sold a half boat. How you think I won best dressed with no support and had them paid lawyers coming in and out of court? Hey, Wando, ATO, ain't it a blessing? We made it out Kentucky after all that happened. After the pre-trials, after the status, after them impact statements, after the castle. Hey, JR, nigga, ain't it a blessing? We made it out of Lansing after all that happened.
That bitch, nigga.
After Michigan State, after Hubbard, when our mans told on us, them bands they took from us. Joy Road, bitch, but the money long is sick.
In basketball, like, as I've grown up, I realized confidence is very, very important. Because if I give you a scenario, like, there's two players, player A and player B. Player A has all the confidence in the world, but he's decent. But player B has no confidence, low self-esteem. Even though he works hard, he's a talented player, but he has no confidence. The player with the most confidence is going to be the best player, because, like, he's able to show all his ability. And in the past, that's something I've struggled with, like, in the past, I let people tell me like what type of player I am and how I should play and all of this stuff. And I let them knock my confidence. But like, as I've grown up, I've grown up and like I've increased in my faith in God, that like my confidence really comes from God and my ability and my hard work. So for me, my confidence therefore comes from God. Like the ability and the talent that He's given me, I believe in that, and I believe in my hard work that I can definitely be the best one day. So. Yeah.
My name is Blessing Amakop. Currently first year at the University of Kent. Also play for the Kent basketball team, and I'm their point guard.
He's not that mobile, but he's calm. Push it.
Come on.
You're a, ooh. Ah.
I started playing ball probably like year seven. I used to be a footballer. I used to play football a lot, but I just kind of lost some passion for the sport. You know, started playing basketball, break time basketball, you know, back in school in London. And then, yeah, it just took off, man. I started playing ball year seven, but I'll say like I started training properly. I wanted to make it when I was like 16, sixth form.
So has there been like any complications? Like what challenges have you faced?
Oh, challenges, I'll say, challenges is somewhat, you could say some, because UK basketball is still growing. So there's somewhat like opportunity problems, but we'll get there in a few years with funding, all of that recognition, we'll get there soon.
Yeah, I know, I've been hearing you lot have been training hard. How's it been like keeping up with like the uni life balance with training and stuff?
Bro, I can't ask a good question, man. Bro, it's been tough. Like balancing school, basketball, like it's hard still. Sometimes like you want to train, but then you got assignment, school work, but just gotta make sure you balance your things out, you can get it done.
One, two, three,
four, five, six,
UBSC!
Hey!
Yeah, so the time that I realised that I was actually like really good at what I'm doing was I used to play for a team named Brentwood Leopards, and we went on a globe tour. So we went to Spain, and it was like a tournament. So we were down by 19 in the third quarter, and then I don't know, something just switched in me. Like everything was just coming to me easy. Like I was making three after three, like bucket after bucket. Like all my defenders, I was making them walk the plank. Like they couldn't guard me. Like I was like, yeah, I can't lie, I'm good at this. I finished like 26 in 28 minutes. And like players from the other team were coming, like, yeah, I can't lie, you're valid. Like, even if their English wasn't good, I still understood. Like, I still understood. But yeah, that game, I realized that, like, yeah, I'm tough. But my favorite players that I like to watch is Kyrie Irving and Kobe. Like, from a young age, all I did was I'd watch Kyrie Irving highlights and Kobe highlights. I'd just sit there in front of the screen for hours and just copy whatever they did. I read it in the notebook, and then I go outside and try it. So like, there was a play that Kyrie Irving had on Damian Lillard when he was in Cleveland. So he went for a two to in or cross to a reverse layup on the right side of the backboard. So I go outside and try the same thing like over and over and over again. And then you gradually start to see you become more able to do those moves, and then your confidence grows. So yeah, those are the players I like to watch. Kobe and Kyrie, those are my favorite players. Yeah, I even have the book on me now. Like, I carry this book with me everywhere. But, I have a book of moves that I saw people do, saw players do. And I just, like, write it down and I copy it. And then I go to the gym and I work on it. Like, so I just do the same thing. I just write it down and I just practice it. Like, I carry this book with me everywhere. So, yeah.